We know that more than 200 Chinese Australians enlisted over the course of World War I. Many Chinese Anzacs were descendants of Gold Rush immigrants who had settled permanently in Australia. An obstacle for many Chinese Australians wishing to enlist was the Defence Act 1909, which prevented those who were not substantially of European origin or descent from joining up. To get around enlistment restrictions, some men changed their names to disguise their heritage. For example, some of the Huey brothers who fought during the war changed their surname to Hughes. As the war progressed, Australia needed more recruits and therefore relaxed requirements. This allowed Chinese Australians such as Samuel Tong Wei, who had previously been rejected for being of non-European origin, to enlist. Some names were recorded incorrectly by recruiting officers who had difficulty spelling Chinese names. This happened to Thomas William R. Chow, whose name was misspelt twice in the records. This can make identifying Chinese Australians in service records challenging. As many as 19 Chinese Anzacs were awarded decorations for their bravery. One such recruit was William Edward Singh, known as Billy, who was born in Clermont, Queensland in 1886 to an English mother and Chinese father. Billy quickly enlisted, signing up in October 1914. Billy's listed profession as a horse driver and his known skill as a marksman made him an ideal candidate for the 5th Light Horse Regiment. Billy sailed from Australia to Egypt in December 1914, before heading to Gallipoli in May 1915. On Gallipoli, Billy became known for his abilities as a sniper. For his role, he was awarded the Distinguished Conduct Medal, DCM, for conspicuous gallantry, courage, and skill. After the evacuation of Gallipoli, Billy was transferred to the 31st Battalion and sent to the Western Front. During his service in France and Belgium, he received further commendations for his gallantry. Billy was recommended for the Military Medal for his actions in the Battle of Polygon Wood, where he was badly injured. On 3rd of February 1918, Billy went on to receive the Croix de Guerre for acts of heroism on Belgian soil. Billy was hospitalised several times during his service, and in 1917, while recuperating in Britain, he married Elizabeth Stewart, a young Scottish woman. Billy Singh embarked for Australia on 21st of July 1918. It is unclear whether his wife ever joined him in Australia. When researching Chinese Anzacs, start by gathering information such as the place they were born and date of birth, as well as variations in spellings or modification of names in order to make them easier to understand in English. Don't forget to look at the MT1486/1 record series for applicants who attempted to enlist but were rejected on medical grounds, or for race or other reasons. To help you get started, these are the names of some Chinese Anzacs to explore. For further help identifying and researching Chinese Anzacs, search the Museum of Chinese Australian History, Trove, Chinese Australian Historical Society, State or University Archives, as well as state or local libraries. Share your World War I research on Discovering Anzacs.